started our fourth lesson, that is operation on fraction. We have seen that a mixed fractions, we have also seen improper fractions, we have seen proper fractions. Before we proceed further, I'm just going to revise the terms, what actually fraction was, what actually improper fraction is, what actually proper fraction is. So just tell me, what is the definition of proper fraction? Yes, the fraction in which numerator is smaller than denominator is said to be as proper fraction. What is improper fraction? Yes, the fraction in which numerator is bigger than denominator is said to be as improper fraction. What is mixed fraction? Fraction which is coming in the combination of an integer and proper fraction is said to be as mixed fraction. We have seen the conversion of improper fraction into mixed, and we have also seen the conversion of mixed into improper. I hope you have understood through the video. So we are going to see now the addition and subtraction of a mixed fraction. There are actually two methods. Which one is easy for you, which one is convenient to you, you are supposed to choose it. So it totally depends upon you. I am just going to show both the methods. So see over here the addition of mixed fraction, what actually we are supposed to do now. See on the board, 2 1 upon 5 plus 3 1 upon 2. What actually we are supposed to do? Now, we are knowing the conversion of mixed into improper. Same way we are going to utilize for the both the one. 5 into 2 plus 1 upon 5. 5 into 2, that is 5 multiplication into 2 plus 1 upon 5 plus as it is 2 into 3 plus 1 upon 2. What I did, just see carefully, 5 into 2 plus 1 upon 5, because denominator was 5, plus as it is 2 into 3 plus 1 upon 2. Okay, now focus on the next part. See here, 5 into 2, what is the answer? 5 into 2 is 10 plus 1 upon 5 plus 2 into 3 is 6 plus 1 upon 2. Right? Now 10 plus 1 is what? 11 upon 5 plus 7 upon 2. Now tell me, denominators are same or not? They are not same. They are not common. So what we are supposed to do? Yes, we are going to do cross multiplication. I hope you are remembering cross multiplication which was done in 5th standard. So cross multiplication, how we are supposed to do? 11 into 2 plus is there in between, so plus 5 into 7, we are going to cross multiply, we are knowing this, 11 into 2, 7 into 5, denominators are 5 into 2 and here also 5 into 2, just see again, 11 into 2 plus is there in between, so plus 5 into 7 or 7 into 5, both side denominators, what will come? 5 into 2 over here, 5 into 2 over here. Now just check, 11 into 2 is what? 22 upon 10 plus 35 upon 10. Now see, denominators are same. If denominators are same, what I am supposed to do? Yes, I am going to keep the denominators common and I am going to add the numerators, that is 22 plus 35 upon 10. 22 plus 35, what is the answer? It is 57 upon 10. Now 57 upon 10. The question was in mixed fraction. So answer also I am going to give in mixed fraction. So 57 upon 10. If I divide 57, just see, by 10. 10, 5 is 50. What is the remainder? 7. How I am going to express this? 10 will be as it is over here. 10 5s are, so 5 is going to come here and what is the remainder? 7. So my answer is 5, 7 upon 10. Now similarly we are going to solve this only question by second method. So first method, what we have did, just I am going to tell you again, 5 into 2 plus 1 upon 5 plus 2 into 3 plus 1 upon 2. We have continued it further, 5 into 2 is 10 plus 1, that is 11 upon 5, 2 into 3 is 6, plus 1, that is 7 upon 2, denominators were not common, so we have did the denominators common. How we have did? We have cross multiplied them. 11 into 2 plus 7 into 5. Both were having denominators 5 into 2, 5 into 2, so 5 into 2 over here, 5 into 2 over here. So this got converted into 22 upon 10, and this got converted into 35 upon 10. So I'm going to add the numerators, that is 22 plus 35, because why? Denominators were common now. 22 plus 35 was 57 upon 10. I have divided in front of you. Denominator was 10, so it remained as it is. The integer part came over here and the remainder part came over here. Now we will solve the same question by the second. Okay, so now the same question by the second method. 2 1 upon 5 plus 3 1 upon 2. How we are going to solve it? Just see. Always remember one thing, this 2 1 upon 5, we can separate them in the form of integer and mixed fraction. I have already told you it is one integer and one is, sorry, the fractional part, the proper fraction. So how I am going to write this? 2 plus 1 upon 5. Okay? Plus sign is there in between. So plus sign 3. Same I am going to do for this 3 1 upon 2. 3 plus 1 upon 2. This is under clear for you. Now see the part which is integer. These integers I am going to take together. I am going to keep them in bracket. This 2 and this 3, which are integers, I have taken them in one bracket. And what I am supposed to do this with fraction? Yes, I am going to take that fractions together. Fine. Now see, your middle sign is plus. That's why everywhere plus is occurred. If it is subtraction, I am just going to tell what you are supposed to do that at that particular time. So 2 plus 3, what is the answer? 2 plus 3, yes it is 5, plus as it is. Now see, the denominators are not same in this question, they are not same in these fractions. So we are going to cross multiply, that is 1 into 2, 1 into 2, plus in between, so plus 5 into 1, 5 into 2 over here, and again 5 into 2 over here. How I am going to write this? 5 as it is, plus 1 into 2 means 2 upon 10 plus 5 upon 10. Fine. So 5 plus 5, 2 plus 5. I am going to write common on the top. Why? Because denominators are same and I am going to write the denominator one time. So 5 plus 7 upon 10. And 5 plus 7 upon 10. How I have written this? Express in such a way. So I can express this also in same way. So it is 5. 7 upon 10. So both the sides you can see the answer is same. So subtraction we will see now. Okay, so now we are going to do the subtraction of this mixed fraction. Same way, method 1, method 2, which one is easier for you? You are supposed to choose it. Fine. So now just see near the board. 5, 1 upon 2 minus 3, 1 upon 3. How we are going to subtract it? First, we are going to start by the regular method, that is 2 into 5 plus 1 upon 2 minus 3 into 3, 3 into 3 plus 1 upon 3. Why this minus came? Because in the original question it was minus, so the middle sign is minus. Now, 2 plus 5, 2 into 5, sorry, 2 into 5 is 10 plus 1 upon 2 minus 3 into 3 is 9. Plus 1 upon 3. So this is 11 upon 2 and this is 10 upon 3. Now just see, denominators are same. No, they are not same. So that's why we are going to cross multiply. How we are going to do it? 11 into 3 minus 2 into 10 or 10 into 2. 10 into 2. Both divided by 2 into 3. 2 into 3. Okay. So now, 33 upon 6 minus 20 upon 6. Denominators are same? Yes. If denominators are same, we are going to subtract the numerators. So 33 minus 20 upon 6. 33 minus 20 upon 6 means what? 33 minus 20 is 13 upon 6. Now the question is in mixed fraction, so answer should be also in mixed fraction. So how are we going to do that? How I am going to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction? Divide it. 6, 2 is 12, remainder is 1. So denominator is 6, so here also denominator will be 6. 6 2s are, so 2 will come over here and remainder is 1. So my answer is 2 1 upon 6. Now we will focus for the next part, that is the method number 2. 5 1 upon 2 minus 3 1 upon 3. By earlier method, what we are supposed to do? Yes, I am going to separate them out. How? How I am going to write is 5 1 upon 2 1 upon 2. 5 1 upon 2 as it is. Okay? This minus sign, so minus over here. 3 plus 1 upon 3. Is this okay for you? Now, whenever you are knowing, whenever there is minus sign and there is a bracket, when the brackets open, the signs inside change. So what will happen? I am just going to open out the brackets. Here what there is no one minus. So this 5 1 upon plus 1 upon 2 will remain as it is. If when I am going to remove this bracket, this 3 will become minus 3 and this plus will get converted, that will become minus 1 upon 3. The reason is whenever the brackets open, the signs inside change. When there is minus outside. Okay. For addition, there is no change in the sign. Now, fractional part I will take together and integer parts I will take together. Which are integer part? That is 5 minus 3 I am going to take together. Why 5 minus 3? Because 3 is having sign that is minus. So this 5 minus 3 I have taken together. Plus this 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 3. Is this okay? Fine. Now 5 minus 3 is what? 2 plus. Now just focus, your denominators are same? No, they are not same. So again we will divide. Then again we are going to cross multiply. 1 into 3 minus 2 into 1 whole divided by 2 into 3 and 2 into 3. Now just see over here, 2 plus, that is 3 upon 6 minus 2 upon 6. Now denominators are same. So 2 as it is plus 3 minus 2 upon 6. Okay. So my final answer is 2 plus 1 upon 6. So I am going to get 2 1 upon 6. So both the sides you can see my answers are same. So always remember one thing, whichever is convenient method for you, you are going to solve by that particular method. You can follow method 1, you can follow method 2. Which you find easy, again and again watch this video so that you will understand the concept very easy. Thank you.